Hey guys, it's Phil from smilinggardener.com. If you haven't checked out my free online organic gardening course, you can do that right on the homepage of smilinggardener.com. And this is the first lesson of this new series. There's not a whole lot of plants going on behind me because it's still early spring, but that's okay because the first lesson always has to be about soil anyway. And a thing I really like to always start talking about is, what is soil made of? How does it form? Just a quick look at this, because soil isn't given the respect it deserves in a lot of circles. Certainly in organic gardening, we think of it a lot differently. Let's have a look at our soil here. Just gotta drink my tea before it gets too cold. So how does soil form? Soil forms from rock. It starts as rock, and then over thousands of years, you have wind coming in, you have rain coming down, you have chemical reactions that occur, and you have temperature changes, freezing and thawing and hot temperatures, and gradually it gets broken down. A lot of this is very physical and mechanical, a little bit of chemical too. But the thing that doesn't get talked about as much is the biology. So the biology is when plants start to come in. There's just enough soil that little plants can come in and little microorganisms come in. And they work together often to start to produce even better soil, and soil that has a little bit of organic matter in there. And so that part is really important. And that's what we talk about in organic gardening. Now, why I want to talk about it today is I just want to get inside all of our heads that we're talking about soil as a vibrant community. It's chemical, it's physical, it's also very biological. So that's what we look at. Now today, I kind of want to just look briefly at the soil texture. And what that really means is the proportion of sand, silt, and clay in your soil. Because mostly that's what soil is. The rock gets broken down into sand, which is pretty big, silt, which is smaller, and clay, which is really, really tiny. So what you do is you try to get a little bit of soil, maybe like a third of a cup, into your hand. Take out the organic debris, try to squeeze it into a ball, and then roll it out into a cylinder. And the more you can do that, the more silt and clay you have. If it doesn't hardly squeeze into anything, you have a really sandy soil. My mic just fell off. Check, check, check. Okay, we're still going. So, the texture influences the structure. And what the structure is how your soil kind of crumbles, how it stays together. A really sandy soil texture doesn't stay together very well, it kind of falls apart. It allows a lot of air in there, but doesn't hold water very well, so that influences how you water. A heavy clay soil holds plenty of water, which is great, but doesn't hold that much air, so you have to think about that. Also influences how you water. Both of them influence how you fertilize, and we're going to be talking about a lot about fertilizer. The cool thing is, even if you have a very sandy soil or a very high clay soil, there's something that can moderate that, and that is organic matter. So here we have leaves that make the best mulch ever. We have straw that makes a pretty darn good mulch too. In here, I have compost that I put in last year, and all of these things are going to serve to really moderate those extremes. So if I get organic matter in there, get humus building in the soil. If I have a sandy soil, which I don't have here, it's going to help that soil to hold a lot more water and hold a lot more nutrition, because sand does not hold nutrients very well at all. If I have a clay soil, getting that organic matter in there is going to allow it to get more air, because the roots need air and the soil food web needs air. It's going to allow it to resist compaction too. And you know, there's so many other things that organic matter does, resisting erosion, providing nutrients, all kinds of cool stuff. So we really are going to be talking about organic matter a lot during this course. So that is just a little introduction to soil. All I really want to get across when I'm talking about soil early on is just how important it is for the garden, and how we can learn a lot about our soil by digging in it. We're going to be focusing on increasing organic matter, increasing minerals, improving the soil food web. It's going to be physics and chemistry and biology. And all of this is so important to have healthy flowers, healthy trees, and especially for nutrient-dense food, which is what I'm really interested in. And I got into a little more detail in the article if you want to read that. That's all. If you're watching this on YouTube, subscribe, because there's a lot more videos in this series coming up. If you're watching it on my website, you can sign up for my email list, and I'm going to send this out to you as we go. I'll see you next time.